first opened in the year 2000. We're live inside Minute Maid Park here in downtown Houston. It's Game 4 of the World Series between the Houston Astros and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vasgersian. Welcome to the World Series here on the show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots of storylines here as we approach the start of Game 4.
Well, I think this series has played out exactly how we expected it to. At 2-1, it's been tightly contested back and forth. We've got two teams worthy of being here, and I think this will go at least 6 games before it's all said and done.
The buildup to this one is just about over. It's time for all the drama of World Series baseball on the show. And we'll have it for you next. Julio Urías is the man on the mound for the 4th game of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, this guy has a 4-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard soft, you can go in and out. And anytime you have 4 pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
So stepping in is Jose Altuve. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. One home. High and deep to left center field. Back goes Pollock. That one is gone. What a way to lead off a ball game. So it's a solo home run here leading off the ball game. His second home run of the series, and the Astros take a 1-0 lead. Just an absolutely amazing home run there. Certainly worthy of the show track treatment. And as you can see, 114 miles an hour off the bat. And that should give you a pretty good indication as to how well he connected on that swing. In now, Alex Bregman. And it's fouled away.
If you're on the mound right here, you got to trust your catcher and execute. You know who's coming up to the plate.
No outs, nobody on. And another foul ball. Ready with the 2-2. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Pollock arranged to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down. Now here's a look at the Astros starting lineup. What do we need to know about these guys for this evening's matchup on the road, D-Row?
Matt, you take a look at this lineup. I find myself thinking back to my playing days when I knew I had the ace on the mound. It had to be win day, and when you get in a car to drive to the yard, you tell yourself, even though you felt bad about it, just get 2 or 3. All the pressure's on the big boy to have to execute, and he usually does. Look for this lineup to try and execute and score, manufacture 1 or 2 runs early in this one. Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
1-2. Swung on and missed, strike 3.
With how hard guys throw these days, 94 miles an hour is good, but not as impressive as it used to be. Professional hitters can catch up with that, so it's all about setting the fastball up with good off-speed stuff to make it look more effective. And that's exactly what he did right there.
Blake now, Carlos Correa.
Into the corner and slicing foul.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin the win if he starts looking for it in there.
set, and the 1-2 pitch. Fouled off. Again, another foul ball. Bases are empty here with two men out. Chases out of his own for strike three, and that's the third out of the inning. But another look here at the solo shot leading off the ball game. Home half of the first coming up from Minute Maid Park, and Houston's off to an early 1-0 lead. Justin Verlander will be on the mound for game four. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, Matty V, this ought to be a fun one to watch. This guy's been around the block for a while, but he's having a rock-solid season with a real good ERA. It'll be really interesting to see how he attacks his opposing lineup.
Striding in is Mookie Betts. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now the 2-1 is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike two. The 2-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Inside, he misses ball four.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Here's Corey Seager. Even now, 2-2. Betts gets his lead at first, nobody out. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2. Justin Turner is on deck. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit on the ground toward the left. Bregman fields it cleanly to Gurriel, and they get them both.
That is good.
Now a moment for the Los Angeles Dodgers starting lineup. Mark, what's your take on him against one of the best starters in the game?
Yeah, Matty, a lot of professional at-bats up and down this lineup. I know they're behind right now, but it only takes one guy to set the tone and get the boys going.
So now to the plate, Justin Turner. Turner in front at 3-3.
This is a good at-bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Full count now, 3-2. Here comes the payoff pitch. Lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. This pitch is taken here for ball four, so the Dodgers able to extend the inning here with two away.
Well, this guy's been prone to giving up walks at bunches, and that's already two walks here in the early going. We'll see if this continues to be an issue for him as this start continues.
So here's Cody Bellinger. set. Here comes the 1-1.
Ball.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Just behind the fastball there. Two strikes now.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. A couple of walks, but no damage. Back with more of Game 4 on the show after this. Cuban import Yuli Gurriel. In past meetings with Julio Urias, he's a perfect 2-for-2. Gurriel behind the ball and two strikes.
One ball, two strikes.
And he chased it in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Gurriel is retired, and there's one away.
Well, you know you made a real nice pitch when you bounce it in the dirt, and you still get the hitter to swing at it. That tells me that there's a lot of deception in that pitch right now.
Into the box now, Kyle Tucker. High and deep down the left field line. Pollock is over now, and he puts this one away in foul territory, and there are two men out.
The center fielder, number 3.
Ready now is Miles Straw. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive.
Ball down low.
You know what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Now the 2-1.
Ball low.
Martin Maldonado would be next. And he looks at ball four now. So he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of a steal when he's on base.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
Now to the plate, Martin Maldonado. In past meetings with Julio Urias, not a big sample size, 0-for-1. Throw over to first. Throw is up the line as it gets away. Strong, the runner at first with two gone. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two.
Two balls, one strike.
And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
And he may be starting to lose the feel here as that misses for ball four, and that's back-to-back walks now with two away.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs, and now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Now to the plate is the Astros pitcher, Justin Verlander. And a chance now to increase his lead if he can deliver something here with two gone. Fouled away.
Hey, I know it's the pitcher at the plate, but he's going to grind it out right here. He's got a chance to help himself, and nothing's a bigger backbreaker to a team than watching the pitcher drive in a run.
One and two, here it is. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Two left for the Astros, and after an inning and a half, it's 1-0. Second set to go, and next will be the speedy catcher, Will Smith. A 1-1. Strike two, swinging.
One ball,
not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks, and even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
Two and two to the Dodgers catcher.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
The 2-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. He might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead, he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
To the plate now, Max Muncy. And he fouls this one off. The next 1-2 pitch. Lays off, 2-2 now.
There's not too many umpires in the game that are going to ring that for a strike right there. That was borderline up, even though it was in the zone.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close.
Called
the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
At the plate, A.J. Pollock. 3-1 to the Dodgers left fielder. And this is taken low for ball four, and they'll have themselves a two-out base runner here after all.
And that hole at bat, I feel like he really didn't want to challenge him. And I'm really surprised by that, because I think this is a guy in the bottom third of the order you have to go right after.
Next, it'll be Gavin Lux, and we'll see if they can make him pay for the two-out walk, always considered a big no-no, of course. The 1-1 home.
Go down.
Wow, that's 40 pitches for him already. This doesn't have the makings of a start that he's going to go very deep.
Two out with the man at first. Now a throw over.
He's
and
dead.
The runner back safely. Now the 2-1. And he gets around on one and hits it high and deep to straightaway right. Tucker has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. One left for L.A. They trail this one 1-0. top of the third set to get underway, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Jose Altuve.
And that was a great swing he put on that changeup last time up to hit that home run. Just an absolutely textbook job of letting it travel, keeping his hands back before exploding on it.
On that fastball is too much for him there, 1-2.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter is going to adjust his batting gloves, and he better be ready in the box.
One and two, here it comes.
I love the fact that the hitter was able to foul that pitch away. I always thought with two strikes, you give the pitcher that inside part of the plate and you do your best to cover away.
Here's another 1-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And look out, that one ran in and got him.
Oh, and that was a big mistake right there. This guy might be their best base stealing threat in the lineup, so now he's got a chance to move into scoring position without even putting the ball into play.
In now, Michael Brantley. And a swing and a miss, and another punch out here. Six already, and that's out number two. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Now a move over to first, and he'll get back in standing. Bregman leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Standing in now, Carlos Correa.
Outside.
Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1.
Hasn't seen a heater yet this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Astros shortstop in front with a 3-1 count.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Full count.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And, whoa, awfully close, but it's ball four, according to Woody Keller.
Well, he's really laboring in the early going here. That's his third walk of the game already. We'll see if he can get it together or if this is just one of those days where he's going to have to grind his way through this start.
So here's Yuli Gurriel looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here. He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those four pitches. Statistics class tells me I'm sitting fast.
Line toward center field. That's in there. Base hit. Now a long throw home. And not in time as the run scores.
Boy, Dero, you have to be licking your chops sitting in a 3-1 count. You get a fastball, he gets it, and doesn't miss it.
Yeah, Dan, that's what you strive for. Find count leverage situations where you can be aggressive. Process of elimination tells you he's got to come fastball or something over the heart of the plate, and he didn't miss it.
Stepping in now, Kyle Tucker. And it's fouled away. Fouled off. Just tried to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2.
Now 2-2. This is the pitch where you want to attack the zone. If you go 3-2, then you put the runners in motion.
And he struck him out. His seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Astros forced to settle for only the one run. Bottom of the third now, and next will be the pitcher, Julio Urías.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
Dodgers pitcher trying to deal with a 1-2 count at the plate.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Julio Urías sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning. Into the box, Mookie Betts. 2-2 pitch is fouled away.
I think for every player, for every former player, that swing right there is the reason we need to extend the netting without question. Want the fans to be safe.
No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2. Pitch home. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
At the plate now, Corey Seager. And he misses, 2-1. Two outs, nobody on, but a base runner here feels like he would really change the complexion of the inning.
Big spot right here. Middle of the order guy is coming up. Let's see if he can extend the inning.
3-1 is the count to the Dodgers shortstop. Drive snagged on a short hop. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They're still down. It's 2-0. And we're back in Houston. Welcome back to Minute Maid Park as we check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros' offense with Houston's manager. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
They've already worked out 3 walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
Thank you, Heidi. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Miles Straw. Here now the 2-2. Oh, forget about this one. Ba-ba-booey. It's up and out of here into the archway. So a solo shot here to left center field, his second home run of the series, and the Astros have taken a 3-0 lead.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
So now to the plate, Martin Maldonado. Fastball laid off well below the knees. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. And the pitch on 2-1. Changeup laid off down around the shins.
The struggles continue, but that happens when you're not able to locate your secondary pitches and become a one-pitch pitcher. He needs to start to get those secondary pitches over really fast.
The 3-1. Three runs, three hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Betts has a read on it. One down.
The pitcher, number 45, Justin Verlander.
So here now is the pitcher, Justin Verlander, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike. Here comes the 1-2. And here's the ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
Now back, second baseman, Jose Altuve.
So it's back to the top of the order now. And striding in, the speedy second baseman, Jose Altuve. The 3-1. And there's a line drive base hit to left field. Two out hit, that'll bring Alex Bregman to the plate as well. That was pretty obvious in live action that that ball was hit hard, and after analyzing it with our show track technology, we see that our eyes did not deceive us. 114 miles an hour was the exit velo, an impressive swing of the bat. Here comes the Dodger manager making his way toward the mound, and it looks as though that's going to be all for his starter here tonight. So he will curiously make his way to the dugout after what has to be considered a very brief appearance.
Please.
Tony Gonsolin answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. In now, Alex Bregman. Fastball called strike, 1-2.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
Here comes the 1-2. Got him swinging in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Astros get a run here courtesy of the solo homer. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 3-0 Houston. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in is the veteran third baseman, Justin Turner. Late on the fastball there as this one skied out toward right. Tucker is in a few steps as he takes it for the first down.
Now, center fielder, Cody.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Cody Bellinger. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat. The Dodgers have yet to break into the hit column here. And it's 1-2.
Got him in a chase after the curveball below the zone there. That was a really nice pitch, and it can be a really tough one to lay off of as a hitter.
Here's the 1-2 delivery.
Ball.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Strong is there now, and he has it to gone.
Now batting, catcher, Will Smith.
And now, Will Smith. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch.
Ball.
No runs, no hits, no errors for the Dodgers thus far. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Dodgers down in order. They trail in this one 3-0. Left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. He went down on strikes last time up. Now here's the pitch. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. Here now the 2-2. Grounded weakly toward third. He's got it. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. So bases are empty with one out now. And the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. Checks his swing, but this will be strike two call. Swing and a flare down the line. That's coming on. He can't get to it. This one's down.
Boy, not the prettiest of swings, D-Lo. That looked a little bit from the Vladimir Guerrero book, but nonetheless, he got the job done.
Yeah, a little choke and poke right there. He flipped a bat out there and was able to find a little empty green grass. Not pretty, but he'll take it.
Into the box now, Yuli Gurriel. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Bellinger's under it. And that's the second out of the inning.
the right fielder, number 30, Kyle Tucker.
So it's a runner at first with two gone, and in to hit next will be the outfielder, Kyle Tucker. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
I know one thing. He earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
Stepping in once again is Miles Straw. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth.
Goes to show you how strong this guy is. That wasn't a bad breaking ball that he hit for a home run in that last at bat. That ball was down and away. He went out and hooked it and pulled it. This guy's definitely a good hitter.
Down and it's up three to a 3-2 full count now. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball. Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. Count still full, 3-2. Another full count pitch home. Back up the middle. First, and the Astros can't cash in as that ends the inning. Two left for the Astros, but they lead it 3-0. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. He said it seems like every at-bat has gone deep into the count, which has resulted in a really high pitch count for their opponent. We checked the numbers. So far, they've worked a total of 6 full counts. Guys?
All right. Thanks, Heidi. And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. Trying to send him packing for the second time. Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
This is why it's so hard to be successful as a hitter when you fall behind in the count. 1-2, you're probably expecting some sort of off-speed pitches, but when the pitcher offers up a good hard fastball, it's pretty hard to adjust and catch up to it.
Stepping in now, A.J. Pollock. Fouled away. The 2-2.
Full count. Three ball, two strikes.
And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
Standing in now, Gavin Lux. Now a swinging bunt that winds up foul.
Man, he's in control of all his weapons right here. One strike away from 5 shutout innings.
There's ball four.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Chris Taylor will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 3, Chris Taylor.
Lux is off of first with 2 away. And he lays off ball 4, so he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit.
Beth.
Now back to the top of the Dodgers order, digging in, Mookie Betts struck out in his last trip to the plate. Two, one, here it is. Swings through it for strike number two.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a strikeout, scored 2-3, and the inning is over. And something about this outing so far is beginning to look awfully familiar, especially in regards to that hit column. Game four rolls along. We're back after this. Corey Knebel takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the Dodgers, number 46, Corey Knebel.
And now here is Martin Maldonado. His head-to-head numbers against Corey Knebel. Small sample, a perfect 1-for-1. The 1-1. And he fouls this one off. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Now, Justin Verlander. A ball and two strikes to the Astros pitcher. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. Bases are empty, one man out. Hit on the ground out to short, right to him. Throw on to first, two gone.
Up next to the Astros, the second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point. Now the 1-1 pitch. Two out, nobody on. Here's another shot down the line in right. Turning for second is Altuve. And he is in the second with a double, his third hit of the night.
The third baseman of the two.
It looks like they'd rather go after the next guy as the intentional walk signal comes here with two away.
Well, they felt it was better to take the bat out of the hands of a guy like that. He's just too dangerous, and they decided they'll take their chances with the next guy in the lineup.
Striding in for Houston, Michael Brantley. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. The 1-1 home.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this. But he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball and play hard.
Strike two called, and it's even to two. Swing and a miss got him reaching. Up with it, Smith. But no chance to get him, and he'll take first after striking out. And not what he wanted to do there, as now they'll need four out of this inning. And now a crucial spot. Bases loaded. Two men gone. And ambling over to the batter's box is Carlos Correa. Here's the 1-1. This is hit softly to third. And they'll go the short way to retire the side. So they load the bases on just one hit, but three men are left stranded. 2, 3, and 4 due up in the home half of the sixth. Houston leads this one 3-0. Here's Corey Seager. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit sharply on the ground. That's a hit, the first in this game for the Dodgers.
Hey, not an easy thing to do right there, D-Row, with that stacked infield on the right side. You hit it through where the shift is, have to hit that in the right place at the right time.
Yeah, he found a good result right there, Dan. Pitcher actually executed right there. Got him to hit it where he wanted to, but good barrel, good contact on that ball, and was able to find the hole.
Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul.
All you want is the leadoff man to get on to start a big inning, maybe get a big rally going to claw your way back into this ballgame.
The 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
I always like watching pitchers that attack with their fastballs until there's a reason to start mixing it up. He hasn't needed many of the secondary pitches so far in this one, and there was another good fastball for a strikeout there.
Into the box, Cody Bellinger. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Seager, base runner at first with one out. On a line to shortstop, but the runner is back in time to avoid the double play.
Super play right there from the shortstop. Talk about showing off those hops. This was destined to be a base hit into the outfield.
So now to the plate, Will Smith.
Go.
Breaking ball there is down. Good job of laying off. It's back to 2-2. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Again, the command is definitely letting him down now. It's ball four.
Well, they've struggled offensively in this one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
Next up is Max Muncy. He's hitless in the game, as is much of the rest of his team. Fouled away. Two men are on with two men out. Fouled off. Again, a 1-2. Look out. Whoa. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Now the pitch. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Dodgers strand a couple. Still down 3-0. Joe Kelly is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 17. Joe Kelly.
Seventh inning ready to roll, and digging in to bat next, the Cuban import Yuli Gurriel. Here's the 1-1. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. It's a breaking ball that couldn't quite catch the inside.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
Set. Here's the 3-1. Grounder got him, but he is able to recover as he gets the out at first. One away now.
Now batting the right fielder, Kyle Tucker.
Next to hit, Kyle Tucker. It was a walk in his last trip. One out, nobody on. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Two and two.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Hit out towards second. Reined in. And there are two away now.
Now batting, number 3.
That would be Miles Straw. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
So a full count now.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Now the payoff pitch home. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Bellinger's under it. And he's got it for the final out of the frame. 1-2-3 go the Astros. But they're on top by a count of 3-0. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Austin Pruitt is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number 6 spot following the double switch. Steven Souza is into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting 9th now on the double switch. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and up next the center fielder A.J. Pollock. Ball and 2 strikes now.
Hey, you want someone sometimes to rattle the bat rack, but also the guy on the mound's got to eat too. They're executing their pitches out there. It's going to be tough to score some runs.
Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
Strong. Slide over and put this one away. And that's out number 1.
The batter, number 9. Second baseman, Gavin Lux.
Now into the box, Gavin Lux. It was a walk in his last trip. Bases are empty, one man out. Lifted down the line and left. Bregman into foul territory, and it's a foul ball. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Matt Beatty will pinch hit here with 2 outs and the bases empty. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Fouled away.
1-2.
Ball.
Pretty good breaking ball to lay off of right there. If I'm pitching, I might think this guy might be sitting on something off speed.
And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. He's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
You know, you don't always have to straight challenge a guy on a 3-2 count. With a three-run lead, no one on base, this is the perfect situation to do it. No reason to nibble and possibly set up a big inning.
Turned on, but it's wide at first and foul. The next 3-2. Grounded back up the middle. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They trail it here 3-0. Scott Alexander has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 75, Scott Alexander.
Digging in will be Martin Maldonado, 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit on the ground to third. And the throw won't be in time as he'll be able to beat out the recovery throw at first.
Well, as we take another look at it, you can see that this thing kind of handcuffed him and he couldn't make the play. Comes off the heel of the glove and the leadoff man is aboard.
At the plate, Steven Souza. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. One there. On to first. Not in time as he just hits the bag ahead of the throw. So that one wasn't quite hit sharply enough to turn two.
Well, when you get a ground ball in a double play situation, you always want to turn it. But that was a tough hit to do it on. You don't want to rush and make a mistake and get no odds. So that was a good job to at least get the runner going at the second.
Jose Altuve will stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. And here you go, a solo home run that had him off and running early on. Hit down the third baseline, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Souza stands at first with one out. Drive base hit into the left center field gap.
Boy, talk about having a day, D-Bro. He gets his fourth knock of the game, but mixed in with one of those four was a round tripper. Not a bad day.
Yeah, you have five, maybe a handful of games that you can throw out four knocks throughout the course of the year. Add in a tater to go with it. He's smiling. His food's going to taste better tonight.
In now, Alex Bregman. Swing and a little tapper. Ball. And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Time to bring you up to date on the numbers for our two starters. It's our starter comparison, and the hometown nine have had trouble generating much by way of hits, as you can see by the left side of your screen. Here's Michael Brantley, a hat trick already to his credit in this one, so he's looking to avoid the dreaded golden sombrero here. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a shot down the line. It's a fair ball. And another runs across as this is now a 4-0 ball game.
Hey, that's what you try and do as an offense. You get a 4-run lead. They're a grand slam ahead, Dan. But you're a former closer. Warm it up. When you see a 3-run lead and then your offense gets it to 4, you know that save situation's gone out the window. Don't tell me that, dude.
Oh, it does. Oh, it does, because, Nero, the only way you're going to get into this game is it has to be a save situation. You sit and watch 8 innings of baseball. You get up to warm up in the ninth, and you're all ready to go thinking, hey, I'm going to come in and get me a 3-out save, and all of a sudden you're out of the game because it's a 4-run lead. Of course you think about it as a reliever.
Standing in now, Carlos Correa.
Ball.
No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
The 2-1. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. 2 down, runners at first and second. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number 3. Astros plate 1 on a couple of hits. Not too many shots left. Home half of the 8th coming up. The Astros 4 and the Dodgers nothing. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Steve Cishek is on to take over on the mound now, and he'll take over the cleanup spot in the lineup following the double switch. Aledmys Diaz is into the ballgame as well as a part of that aforementioned double switch, as he'll take over in the number 6 spot in the lineup. So that'll bring in Mookie Betts, 0-for-2 for him to this point. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Here comes the 1-2.
What pitch recognition right there. 90% of the guys are going fishing after that nasty slider.
The 2-2. And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. Souza is under it. Makes the play. 1 away.
The batter, number 5, shortstop, Corey Seager.
Next at the plate will be Corey Seager. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. 1 out, nobody on. Grounded softly down the line toward first. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. Now here it comes. A swing and a miss for out number 2, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with.
Wow, that's the case right there where a pitcher knows this guy's up there. He's in swing mode. That pitch wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he still swung at it.
Next, here is Justin Turner, and they're down to their final 4 outs here, Dan.
Yeah, and it's not looking too good for them right now, Matt. They've got a significant hill to climb, but they've got to take it 1 bat at a time. A couple of guys get on, and then who knows what could happen.
One and one, here it is.
Ball. 2 balls.
One strike.
This one on to first as they're kept off the scoreboard again, and the inning is over. Dodgers down in order. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. Blake Treinen enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth.
Right there.
Set to start the ninth in this one, and digging into bat next, the Cuban import Yuli Gurriel. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number two. Now the 2-1 pitch is taken high above the zone.
Well, that's ball three, and the Astros right now would do anything to get this leadoff hitter on.
The 3-1 pitch. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
That is not the way he wanted to start off this half inning. It's one thing to walk the leadoff hitter, but it's even more painful when the leadoff hitter is an absolute burner and he can really wreak some havoc on the bases.
And that'll bring up Aledmys Diaz. Career against Blake Treinen. He's 1-for-3. Ready with the 1-1.
No.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
Gurriel aboard here at first with nobody out. And he lays off again, ball three.
This situation right here reminds me of sitting on the bench talking to John Smoltz, Hall of Famer. He would always say, even though the situation looked bad, a pitcher is one pitch away from getting himself out of a tough jam.
And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
Well, he walked him on five pitches, but that last pitch was really good. He missed down, but only by a hair. When a hitter has a 3-1 count, he can wait until he gets a pitch he loves.
So next to hit is Miles Straw. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
If he uses aggressiveness against him right here, you're going to get a swing outside the zone. 1-1. Might as well fish a little bit further.
Here comes the 1-2. It's laid off for ball two.
He went deep earlier, so that might have been a little bit of a message they were trying to send to hit him off the plate. At the very least, they're clearly trying to get him from getting his arms extended again.
And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2. Martin Maldonado is on deck. Hit sharply on the ground. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Bellinger fields cleanly. And they'll add another as this is now a 5-0 game.
Even though that pitcher was able to execute in off the plate, batter was able to keep his hands inside that baseball and drive it up the middle.
Stepping in now, Martin Maldonado. Maldonado behind the ball and two strikes. First and second here with nobody out. contact on that swing and will do it again on 1-2. From the stretch. And this is swung on and missed. And boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand. So they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Into the box, Steven Souza. And the good fastball there finds the zone as the count goes full now, 3-2.
Can't come out of his game plan right here. He knows he's a known sinker baller. I know it was a four-seamer right there, but get back to that two-seam. It's what his MO is.
Now the payoff pitch home. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Right about now, the manager's questioning his decision to bring this guy in. If you can't trust a reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
Victor Gonzalez enters the game with one gone in the top of inning number nine. Next will be Jose Altuve. He hits here in a spot where he might be able to put this one out of reach.
Yeah, Matt, down five, another run across here could very well put the nail in the coffin. Mentally, they might still feel like they've got a shot if they can get out of this jam, though.
The ball and two strikes.
1-2.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes.
Ball.
Bases
balls,
are loaded with only one out. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The 2-2 one more time. Swing and a liner. And that's in there. Base hit. And the runner from third crosses the plate. It's a 6-0 ball game. Boy, and they have not been able to get him out. This is now a 5-hit ball game for him here. And those don't come along every day. Now, Alex Bregman. Now, this is on the ground at first. We'll see if they can get two. There's one. And the pitcher covering at first, and it's your textbook 3-6-1 double play that'll get him out of the inning. On to the bottom of inning number nine. 4, 5, and 6 coming up. The Astros on top, 6-0. Now, the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Joe Smith is into the ballgame as part of that double switch as he'll take over on the mound and in the two spot in the lineup. Abraham Toro is also into the ballgame now as he'll bat cleanup now in the back half of the double switch. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And here comes Cody Bellinger. Set. Here comes the 1-1. Popped up. Toro's on the run. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow.
Now batting. Catcher.
Here now is Will Smith. It was a walk in his last trip. straight back. Bases are empty, one man out. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Gurriel is there, and there are two men gone now.
Now back, the first baseman, Matt Muncy.
Dodgers are down to their final out now, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. The 1-1 pitch. Hey. Barring any late turnaround, this win would belong to Justin Verlander. The Dodgers down to their final strike, and he fouls this one off. One strike from a shutout. Here it comes. Ball two. Two out, nobody on. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Anytime you can win a game, let alone on the road, you have to feel really good about yourself. It's not easy going into that other team's ballpark and coming out with a win, but they did just that.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. A 6-0 shutout to finish off tonight's game. The Houston Astros move a win away from a championship as they've taken a 3-1 series lead. Justin Verlander is credited with the win. Julio Urías couldn't escape the fourth inning as he slapped with the loss. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 6 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 15 runners on base. For the Dodgers, no runs, just one hit, one error. They left 6 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 47 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.